Fuck the pep talk. Fuck the motivational talk. Mr. McMahon seemed to reluctantly provide his.
Well, he didn't get to give him that talk growing up.
No matter what it's like growing up, McMahon.
No.
Poor little Hornswoggle missed out on a lot. Chauffeur-driven bicycles.
And making his way to the ring, Hornswoggle.
Well, Mr. McMahon has encouraged his illegitimate son to learn to hate. Because with hate comes success, according to the chairman of the WWE.
There's a hateful look on down of the coachman's face.
The coachman is all business here tonight.
Well,
one can only imagine what it would be like to...
Coachman has said he thinks he'll be doing the McMahon family a favor if he can completely eliminate Hornswoggle.
A lot of upsets in college football. Can you imagine how Coachman would look, how he would feel?
That'd be an upset.
Yes.
Coach has got socks taller than Hornswoggle.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, here is your special guest referee.
Special guest referee.
Oh, no! Foley's baby boy, the hardcore legend himself, Mick Foley.
I'm not hating this, I'm loving it.
Mick Foley knows how to deal with success. Another lesson Mr. McMahon was talking to his son, Hornswoggle, about.
Look at John of the Coachman, he's hating now.
Kind of surprised to see in this match Mick Foley
is a low five.
Hey, I didn't see a special referee coming, but certainly not Mick Foley here. And I think John the Coachman is somewhat perplexed and confused that it's Mick Foley, the third man in the ring.
Look, Mick Foley checking Coachman over. He could be concealing some sort of foreign object.
Whoa. Foley watched Dick Worley as a kid. He's got all this referee stuff down.
Are you ready? Let's wrestle. Wait.
All right, well, here we go. This is a one-fall match. And please don't talk about a short arm scissor.
That's a legitimate hold.
Down the coachman stalking.
Whoa.
Little Hornswoggle.
Wants to make short work of this opponent. Go.
Did you notice the smile and the sparkle in the eye of Hornswoggle? Hey, look at that. Where is it? Hey, there's some hate.
I thought you better look out.
I think Hornswoggle had some, he had some hate raid on the way out. The gleam of the little guy's eye.
Wait. Got the beard. Be careful, coach. You know where he punches.
Well, this is obviously not fair. It's a...
No biting.
No!
Well, that was a rather unorthodox maneuver, to say the very least.
Another drop kick.
Hey, is that a cover?
And a coachman.
Oh, man. I think John the Coachman has underestimated the ability of the public enemy to tackle.
And the
those high-risk maneuvers for the guy.
Mr. McMahon's illegitimate son, Hornswoggle.
Came off the bottom rope.
Misses the elbow. Somewhat obstinate.
Come on, coach. Oh, no.
Hey.
I
don't think that was intentional.
Well, that was. That was certainly intentional. John the Coachman with a cheap shot on Mick Foley. Oh, you got to be kidding me. John the Coachman bringing a steel chair in the ring to use on little Hornswoggle.
Let's take the big man, doesn't it?
Oh, boy. What a big... big shot. Coachman is. Socko's little brother.
No.
And it was also. This is too close. Look at this. Coach. Coach is going to hate this. The Socko. Hornswoggle! Oh! A frog splash! A frog splash! And a three count!
I think that would be a tadpole splash!
Here is your winner, Hornswoggle!
Well, Mr. McMahon called his illegitimate son a frog and a toad. Maybe it was a toad splash. In any event, Hornswoggle McMahon has beaten William Regal's executive assistant, Jonathan Coachman.
Can't wait to go back and tell Pop what a great job he did.
And you know the little guy wants to make his dad proud of him.